on, Ma, we'll board everyone.
Crooked, Mr. Dewey. Crooked.
Mother wanted me to give this to Mr. Baines. I thought maybe it was not the proper thing to do. Shall I open it?
No. Give it to me.
No.
Come to. Go to
the car. Go
I trusted you, dear. Why did you make me hurt you? Why did you hurt me? You made me angry.
In this crucial scene of the film, Flora takes the message that Ada wrote for Baines and gives it to Ada's husband, Alistair, and Alistair savagely chops off Ada's finger with his axe. The shots in the beginning of the scene are already foreshadowing the upcoming climax. After Flora decides to change her path, we see a low angle shot of her running up the hill, which makes her appear more powerful visually to imply that she had the control of the situation. But when Alistair learns about the note, Flora is no more the main figure in the frame. The camera starts to follow Alistair with the axe and leaves Flora behind, which demonstrates that Alistair is now having the power over the situation. Then they pass through the dark forest. The harsh environment and the pouring rain illustrate the hopeless and depressive emotions. Then we see a close-up shot of the axe, which again foreshadows the tragical climax. In the movie, the axe symbolizes the phallic destruction. It appeared once in the play of Bluebeard where he murders his wife. Using the axe, Alistair slashed the table and then the piano, which was a medium for Ada to express her feelings and desires throughout the movie. This shot shows Alistair's intention to cut off the sound of Ada's voice. Then, Alistair drags Ada from the house into the rain. The outdoor setting is filled with cold colors which dramatically contrast with the warm and bright lighting inside the house. The harsh and gloomy outdoor environment illustrates Ada's hopelessness and sadness at that time. The rain and the mud also contribute to depict the horrible feeling of the scene. The action of chopping off Ada's finger symbolizes castration. Alistair knows that he has no control over Ada's desires, sexuality, and spirit. So he tries to cut off her desires by symbolically castrate Ada. His anger might come from his own existential lack, which caused his own fear of castration. In psychoanalysis, the phallus is a signifier of social power and prestige. Since Alistair was not even able to receive love from Ada, he got the fear of losing his phallic power that he should have over Ada in the marriage, according to the old-fashioned social norms, since they used to believe that the husband automatically owns the wife. Therefore, pushed by his own castration anxiety, Alistair uses the axe as a symbol of phallic destruction to cut off Ada's desire in order to fill up his own emotional lack. Also, the costume is a significant element in the movie. When Ada first arrived on the island, the Maori woman described her as an angel. Toward the end of the movie, Flora often wears the white angel wings on her back, and she was wearing the wings again in this particular scene. Angel often symbolizes something pure and innocent, and represents what is right. From another perspective, Flora with the angel wings could be representing the superego of Ada, which reminds her of her duty to stay loyal to her husband. According to Freud, the superego operates as a moral conscience that suppresses the unconscious desires that are often socially unacceptable. We can see that Flora with the angel wings always reminds Ada to not visit Baines. She even helped Alistair to cover up the window with the wood. The angel Flora is a stand-in for Ada's superego. In this scene, Flora's white angel costume contrasts with the Ada black dress, which suggests again their opposition. In psychoanalytic theory, the superego is in direct opposition to the id. Id is the source of human instincts, desires, and libido, which is the sexual energy. Here, Flora still represents the superego, and Ada, wearing the opposite colors, becomes a representation of her own id. When Ada experienced her castration by losing her finger, Flora got blood over her face and she becomes dirty with the mud over the body. Later, her wings got taken off and got washed in water, which means that Ada's superego is also now castrated. This was also the moment when Ada finally stops struggling with the moral constraints and follows her will of living with Baines at the end of the movie.